Hello, everyone. Good morning. Thank you, Suzette. My name is Masoud Beheshti. I manage the application and marketing group at TI's linear power product line. Welcome to today's session. We are going to talk about low power precision data conversion with one of the industry's lowest IQ voltage reference. We have a number of topics that we have lined up today. We're going to talk first about some of the key specifications for voltage references. We will then introduce REF35, which is a leadership device in this space. We will provide some application examples and then talk about the portfolio of series voltage references that we offer today. Joining me today is Trilokia Ray. He's one of our senior application engineers. He's monitoring the chat line and will be answering your questions as we go along. So feel free to ask any questions you have, and we'll do our best to answer those. So with that, let's get started. So as most of you already know, sensors and data converters are commonly used in a wide range of applications to convert analog signal to a digital stream. As you can see in this diagram here, when you have a data converter, you typically have a precision external voltage reference that is used to make a repeatable and accurate measurement possible. These voltage references are designed to be very stable over any types of variation in terms of input voltage, operating temperature, aging of the system, humidity, and many other factors. And we're going to actually look at some of those factors this morning and talk about those. Ultimately, what we need to keep in mind is that we want to really make sure that this reference stays stable, because any changes in the output of this voltage reference will impact both either static or dynamic performance of the data converter, or what we refer to as ENOP, effective number of bits of resolution of the converter. So let's talk about temperature drift first. Temperature drift, you also hear people call that temperature coefficient, is essentially a specification that looks at change in the reference voltage over the operating temperature of the device. And obviously, temperature drift impacts the gain error of the data converter, and in turn, impacts the system accuracy. You can see in the diagram here, this is a typical plot that you'll find in many data sheets for series references, and essentially shows an output shift in PPM over the temperature range of the device. There are different methods actually used in the industry to specify temperature coefficient or temperature drift. We at TI use what's known as the box method that actually looks at the max and mean of the voltage reference over the full operating temperature. And we believe that actually provides the most accurate indication of the actual drift and also maximum drift or maximum variation expected over temperature. REF35, which is a device we're going to talk about later, actually provides a very low drift of only 12 ppm per degree C over the full temperature range of minus 40 to 105 degrees Celsius. So pretty key spec, and we'll touch on that a little bit later as well. The second spec that we're going to talk about is, sorry, bear with me. My system is not responding.
Masoud, let me know if you need me to pull up your slides.
You may need to do that, Suzette. I think, no, here we go. Let's try this.
All right. Okay, perfect.
So next we're gonna talk about noise. And this is specifically talking about the internal noise of the voltage reference, which in turn causes dynamic error in the data converter. and impacts the signal-to-noise ratio and effectively the effective number of bits in the system. And there are two types of noise that we typically talk about. The first one is a low-frequency flicker noise, which is typically in the 0.1 to 10 hertz range. And this is usually specified as a peak-to-peak value in 10 millisecond window. This is actually a very critical spec because, as most of you know, flicker noise is very difficult to filter in the system. So you do want to start with a voltage reference that has inherently low flicker noise spec. Because if the flicker noise is high, you have to essentially live with it. The higher frequency noise, which is known as the noise density, 10 hertz to 10 kilohertz, that's the second parameter that it's shown in most data, most voltage reference data sheets. And it's an easier one to filter just because it's at the higher frequency. On the REF35, which has exceptionally low noise, we'll talk about the specs in a minute, we also provide an additional knob, which is called noise reduction pin, to further minimize any flicker noise in the system. And that's actually a pretty handy feature to use in many applications. Last and not least is the long-term stability, or drift, as you may refer to it. This is actually also a pretty critical spec. It describes the shift in the output of the voltage reference after 1,000 hours, which is about 6 weeks of continuous operation under nominal conditions. So essentially, you want to see how, as the device ages in the system, how its output changes. And as you know, most systems, you do not want to calibrate or recalibrate the system once it's deployed in the field. So this is a critical spec that essentially tells you how often, if any, you need to, think about a system recalibration. And so looking at this data, you have an idea in terms of the stability of the reference voltage over the life of the application, and if there are things you need to do to compensate for that. REF35, as an example, has a very exceptionally low long-term stability, or only 40 ppm after 1,000 of operation. So pretty stable device. And we even offer devices that have lower long-term drift, and we show those towards the end. So with that, let's move on to REF35. This is a new leadership device that we released about a month ago. It's a ultra nanopower voltage reference. We call it ultra nanopower because the power supply is only, the power supply consumption is only 650 nanoamps. Exceptionally good initial accuracy of 0.05%, low temperature drift of only 12 ppm, and flicker noise, as you recall, we talked about this a couple of slides ago, which measures the noise over 0.1 to 10 hertz is only 3.3 ppm peak to peak. We offer 10 different voltage variations, and this allows you to pretty much attach this device to any data converter, ADCs or DACs in the market, or it also provides some of the more commonly used references that are used in signal chain designs, whether it's powering a or providing a reference to a precision amplifier, current sense amplifiers, and so on. Very small package, 6-pin SOT23. And you can see a simplified schematic here. I pointed out earlier that we do have a noise reduction pin, which is optional and allows you to further reduce the flicker noise in the system as well. We also provide an enable pin, which puts the device in a super low power mode if you want to further reduce power consumption between measurements in your system. The last thing I want to point out here is this device actually attaches very well to some of the TI's data converters, such as the ADC 34, 35, 36, but also many other that I have not listed here that we offer today. This is a plot of our power consumption for this device. As you can see, it's pretty low, but also stays pretty stable over the temperature range of the device. So it's really ideal for low power applications where you really care about minimizing any any excessive current drawing the system. If we compare REF35 with some of its close competitors, it has it shines across all specs, whether it's supply current, temperature drift, or noise. So it's really an ideal device, not only for low power, but high precision applications that we're going to talk about momentarily. So let's take a look at some application examples. This device can be used in a wide variety of applications where precision and low power are required. I have some examples listed here in medical, electrocardiogram, insulin pump, blood glucose meter, CT and PET scanners, and so on are very commonly used for this device. Many applications in grid, including fault indicators, smart meters, string inverters. And as you can see, a long list of use cases in factory automation and control, especially in field transmitters. And we'll talk about why this device actually fits very well in those applications. And finally, automotive, whether it's HEV, EV, battery management, in the camera system or in the passive safety solutions for either traditional or HEV, EV vehicles. So let's start with one example. The first one is a medical applications for sensor patches. REF35 low power consumption actually eliminates the need to do sampling in some of these applications. So you can actually use it for continuous monitoring of vital signals in the patient. In these applications, as you can see in the block diagram, there's typically a ECG front end with FPGA and ADC, and the voltage reference, such as REF35, is used to provide a precise signal to the data converter block. We commonly see 1.2 and 2.5 volt voltages used in this application, and some of the companion data converters that are provided by TI includes AFE 4960, 4300, ADS 1292, and ADS 1191. And REF35 actually pairs very nicely with those devices. Electrocardiogram is another application. Again, this is something that you want to minimize power consumption and provide long battery life to the end user, along with high accurate sensor measurement. These applications, we actually see different types of voltages used, 2.5, 3 volts, 3.3, and 4 volts in the analog front end block. And some of the common ADCs that are used in this application includes ADS 1292, R and non-R, and 1298. And again, REF35 provides these voltages that I've listed here for these applications. Insulin pump is another medical applications. Again, you're looking for small footprint. These are typically battery operated and rated for a wider temperature range, depending on how the patient is actually, where the patient is using it. One thing that's very critical is a sub 1 microamp quiescent current for this, because you want to maximize battery life, but also temperature drift is a key spec that designers care about in this type of applications. We commonly see 3 and 3.3 volt references being used with the ADCs, such as the AFE 4960, 4300, 1292, and 1191 in these, and we pair well with those devices as well. This is another application. It's a fault indicator for power line. These typically actually use a D2A converter with a 1.2 volt reference. 1.2 volt reference is actually not a very common output voltage that's provided by different semiconductor manufacturers in this space. So this is actually a unique feature that we offer. So we do have a 1.2 voltage very variation of this device that provides this this voltage. Again, long battery life is a critical care about, but as you can imagine, this fault indicator is, you know, sits on the power line, so it's subjected to both 60 hertz or 50 hertz line frequency, but also noise from the communication, which is typically wireless. So noise immunity is actually a key care about in this application, and that's where REF35 shines for this type of implementation. So DAC 101 is commonly used in this application, and we pair well with that device as well. Another great example are the field transmitters. So the field transmitters come in different variety. They're actually used in factory automation to monitor different parameters such as pressure, flow, temperature, level, displacement, so on and so forth. And there are a couple of key careabouts in this application. The first one is precision, because you do want to make a very accurate measurement of these different parameters and feed it back to the system. But also these devices get subjected to a fairly large temperature swing, typically all the way down to minus 55, all the way up to 125. So temperature drift is a key care about. Noise obviously is important, but a lot of these actually run from a very low power source, like a 420 milliamp source. So being able to minimize power consumption is also very important. So 3 volt and 2.5 are the typical voltages that we see in this application. And you can see some of the common ADCs that are used in different types of field transmitters. And these are all covered by REF35. With that, I want to spend a couple minutes talk about the broader portfolio of series voltage references that TI offers. So we actually put our devices into these four families. So we do, and these are typically designed to address different number of bits of resolution, but different carabouts in the system. So for really low resolution application, typically, you know, about, you know, 10, 12 bit, are simple shunt devices such as the LM4040, are you commonly used to provide the voltage reference to data converters. As we move to the nano power series, this is where extending the battery life, but at the same time being able to provide very precise measurement and, you know, low temperature coefficient, noise, and long-term drift becomes important. So REF35 is the device we talked about today, which shines very well in this series. Our mid-range actually covers a wide range of applications from 12 to 18 bits, commonly used in a lot of industrial and automotive applications. A lot of leadership devices in this space, such as the REF34, REF4132. For application that require two outputs, we offer REF20. You can see some of the key specs on this chart. So the first spec is the temperature drift, second one is noise, followed by IQ, and then the last spec is long-term drift. Finally, for high precision application, this includes a lot of implementations in test and measurement, medical imaging, or any other application that uses high resolution data converters, typically more than 20 bits. We have two leadership devices in that space, REF50 and REF70. REF70 particularly, which was released last year, has industry's lowest noise, 0.23 microvolts peak to peak, but also exceptionally low long-term drift of 28 ppm. The TEMPCO is also extremely low at 2 ppm per degree C. So this device is commonly used in a lot of test and measurement applications, whether it's instrumentation, you know, battery test equipment, semiconductor testing, and so on and so forth, for that reason. So So that brings us to the end of our presentation. We also provide a lot of tools for REF35. You can actually access the full data sheet on the product folder, ti.com/REF35. We have released one reference design and we have more coming. We have a GaN-based 6.6 kilowatt bidirectional onboard charger that we have done with REF35, and that's available on this link. We have released a technical blog on using REF35 in low power medical applications. And we have a evaluation platform that's readily available on our website for evaluating this device with different data converters. So to wrap up, precision voltage references are essential in any data converter application. They're designed to be very stable over variations in input voltage, temperature, aging, and other factors. In low power applications, particularly the quiescent current plays a key factor in selecting the selection of the voltage reference. And then finally, as we talked or went into REF35 details, is industry's lowest power consumption at 650 nanoamps, exceptionally good initial accuracy of 0.05% with 12 ppm per degree C temperature drift. And finally, 10 voltage options to support any data converter or signal chain design for different applications that you may have. So with that, I'd like to thank you for your time and feel free to ask any questions that you may have. Hopefully, Trailoki have been answering some of your questions, but if you have any more questions, please, we have